first because the disruptions to trade through the enactment of tariffs, through even the certain randomness and discretion with which those have come and left, have both led to a decline in the ability of firms to organize production, a disruption in supply chains of different types, as well as more generally a pessimism on the investors, especially on the side of firms, which have found it very difficult to make investment plans when they don't know how expensive will it be to get a part from this country or to be able to export or sell to another market. So insofar as it's increased uncertainty and also increased significantly the cost of doing business to many industries, both in the US and China, that is immediately serves as a trigger for recession. On top of it, because the world is interconnected, of course, if Chinese firms cannot sell as much as they thought they would to the US and they're holding back to understand, they're also importing less machinery from the UK because they don't know if they can really build a new plant because they don't know if the market will be there. And as a result, that has propagated in some ways. So in that first way, directly through his trade policies, he has contributed to the potential recession next year. The second one is just more generally through his reactions to monetary policy in particular. He has made the job of the Fed much harder insofar as the fighting of a recession will be constrained by at the same time not losing its independence towards the presidency and the pressure it's been on, and more generally through a certain erraticness of some policies which make it hard or easy for potentially businesses to become pessimistic about the future.